Welcome to Grafana 11 for the users. In this video, we'll deep dive into all of the new features which are important to new beginners and power users of Grafana. Grafana operators and developers, don't panic. There are dedicated videos for you as well. Let's jump straight into one of the most exciting new features, Explore Metrics. PromQL. For some it brings joy, and for others it sends shivers down their spine. Explore Metrics is a new feature that allows you to bypass writing PromQL entirely. The new queryless interface provides a bird's eye view of all metrics stored within your Prometheus data sources. In Grafana 11, you should see a new entry underneath Explore within the navigation menu called Metrics. Selecting this takes you to the Metrics Explore app. Let's create an initial exploration together. After clicking New Metric Exploration, we can now start to visually navigate metrics for each Prometheus compatible data source you have available. Why don't we start by selecting a metric taken from our new data collector called Alloy? From there, we can start to navigate through different panels to understand our selected metrics, whether this be filtering by a label or looking at associated metrics. Let's filter by a label called Service. Once we're happy, we can move this result into our Explorer panel, which auto-generates the PromQL. We can then either move this into a dashboard directly or add further PromQL transformations. Next on our list is Scenes-powered dashboards. Migrating our Grafana dashboards over to Scenes provides us with more stable, dynamic, and flexible dashboards. You will notice some early benefits, including faster loading times and edit mode, which can be found in the top right corner of your dashboard. When toggled on, this puts you in dashboard edit mode and provides a new menu with asset creation options such as add visualization and row. We hope this new home will help clean up the dashboard menu bar. You can also see as we scroll throughout our dashboard that the time picker and dashboard variables snap to the top as we scroll, a much requested feature within our Grafana community. And this is just the beginning. Scenes will provide the foundation for what we envision the future of Grafana dashboards to be. Talking about dashboards, let's take a deeper look into our dashboard changes coming within Grafana 11. The first stop on our tour is the Canvas panel. We've improved the overall experience when creating and updating canvases. In this example, we're going to update a diagram showcasing data being taken from a wind turbine. The wind turbine data is now being sent to the cloud, so we're going to add the cloud icon asset. Cloud is one of the newly added assets alongside parallelogram and triangle. Next, let's add an arrow and run through some of the new midpoint controls. We can select our new arrow from the middle and snap this into a corner shape. We can also add a radius to our arrow to smooth out the sharp corners within our diagram. This can also be done for shape assets like rectangle. Lastly, we'll inspect our windmill via a drone. So let's add that icon and utilize the new rotation feature. This, alongside with the button feature, provides you with a far more immersive experience building out network maps or SCADA solutions in Grafana. You can now also color full rows within the table visualization. This makes it easier to quickly find outliers within your table view. To apply this feature, we're going to highlight all beholder beasts in red. We have pre-added a value mapping already. Next on our list is to add a field override. We will do this by name and select the beast name. Finally, add a property, select cell type, and select colored background. Select toggle to entire row, and there you have it. We can then sort to find the beholder beast. Let's also take a look at the LLM app now available within Grafana OSS, which allows you to utilize large language models such as OpenAI to generate titles and descriptions on your behalf. To start, make sure you enable the LLM app. This can be done via administrations, plugins and data, plugins. You can then search for the LLM app. Once here, you can select your chosen LLM from the dropdown, provide your connection credentials, and then save and test. Once we've done this, we can then jump into our chosen visualization, a time series graph, which is currently named Foo. We can update this to something a little bit more descriptive. What we're going to do is click auto-generate and OpenAI does the rest. That looks pretty good, but let's see if we can improve it by having a conversation with our LLM. I'm going to provide more information about the query. And with that, I'm pretty happy. So let's also update the title. We hope this feature will help to provide an improvement to your productivity as you scale with your Grafana dashboards. Remember to check out our other visualization updates, such as a fantastic community contribution allowing you to set threshold colors based on a query. The filter data by value transformation has also been updated to enable partial string matching. And our X and Y chart is now officially supported with documentation. So last but not least, let's talk about improvements to alerts. We have improved the alert detail view to provide a more comprehensive view of alert rules. This includes helpful metadata at the top, and the namespace and group are now shown as part of the breadcrumb navigation trail. You can also refer to the query being used to trigger the alert, as well as see standard visualizations of time-ranged-based queries. We also have a new option for the configure node data and error handling rules. Keeping the last state allows Grafana to retain the last known value before a no entry or execution error. This is a particularly powerful feature as it provides you with a historical context on why a potential error or timeout might have occurred when the error was last triggered. And that's it for our Grafana 11 user walkthrough. There are also more features that we didn't showcase here today, such as a massive time reduction within the PDF exports for our cloud and enterprise users. Make sure to check out our Grafana 11 for the operators and developers videos when they release for more great features on Grafana 11. Once again, a massive thank you to our Grafanista developers and our community members for making Grafana 11 possible.